Hello, welcome. After years without significant updates, Citra, a project that many considered practically abandoned, surprised everyone with a highly anticipated update. Here on the channel, we have already discussed twice the expected improvements in the project once the Vulkan implementation was finally completed. Last Tuesday, on the 16th, they publicly released the version with the Vulkan API, which had been under development since last year. To take advantage of this API, you need to use Citra Canary, which is provided for free during installation. In preliminary tests conducted by the development team, it was observed that some games had their performance doubled or even tripled when using the Vulkan API. Therefore, today we will definitively explain why Vulkan offers so many advantages over OpenGL, as well as make a comparison between the two APIs under identical circumstances. However, before that, we would like to thank those who support our project, as they make it possible to produce videos like this one and many others firsthand for you. Before we begin our comparison to assess the real performance gain, let's clarify for those who don't know why so many emulators currently implement Vulkan and why Vulkan is the API that offers better performance in emulators nowadays. Firstly, Vulkan is a more recent and updated API compared to OpenGL. The first game to have Vulkan support was the Talos Principle in 2014, while the first game with OpenGL support was Quake in 1996. So, a more mature API in the market should have better performance, right? Wrong. When the last update of OpenGL was released in 2017, with OpenGL 4.6, Vulkan was still in its early stages. AMD, which at that time was behind Nvidia in the market, decided to bet on this new API, redirecting part of its development team to ensure improvements in their hardware. Therefore, Vulkan has an optimized part of the code specifically for AMD, which explains why this API works so well on their products. However, Nvidia users can also achieve excellent results with this API. If you want a more in-depth video about APIs and the advantages of Vulkan in games, leave a comment, and I will consider the possibility of producing a video exclusively on this topic. Overall, Vulkan has become the leading API for both emulation and mobile devices. As mentioned in our previous video, some games experienced crashes during startup when using the Vulkan API. At the time of this recording, this issue still persists but has become rarer. I tested a total of 15 games, and the only ones I couldn't launch were Mario Kart 7, even after watching videos of other users testing it on Vulkan and Kirby Planet Robobot. Another important detail for more demanding players is the motion control system. Although the emulator supports controllers with the SDL API, motion controls do not work natively. The use of DS4 Windows is necessary for motion controls to function correctly. Upon launching DS4 Windows, the motion controls are properly recognized. In the description, I will provide all the settings used in image format, following the standard adopted in all our previous videos. For all tests, the resolution used was 5 times the native resolution, which means 2000 by 1200. If you experience performance issues while running any game, lowering the resolution can significantly improve performance. Additionally, all games will be run at unlimited speed and with unlocked FPS, solely for benchmark purposes. Therefore, the results reflect the maximum that my PC can handle. I will only comment on games in which I have something to mention regarding bugs I encountered or additional settings I adjusted. Now that you know a little bit about APIs and are aware of the small innovations brought by Citra, let's proceed with the graphical comparison. Luigi's Mansion 2 was one of the games I was most excited to play on this system. However, in previous versions, it had terrible performance. But now, it's finally playable. I tried it at 5 times the native resolution, and the game was slow. When using 2 times the native resolution, I achieved a decent image result on a full HD screen with an acceptable frame rate. If you play at the native resolution, it can maintain a constant 60 FPS. I must warn you that this game still has random crashes. Therefore, if you decide to play it now, I recommend saving frequently using save states. In Metroid Samus Returns, we now have a significant performance gain, reaching over 200%. Now, in Pokémon Ultra Moon, in the latest versions, we had compatibility that was rated as bad. However, as you can see, the game now easily reaches over 350 FPS on both APIs. There might still be some issues with gameplay, but in terms of performance, definitely not. Firstly, I would like to clarify that the screen flickering is due to the game not being able to run with VSync disabled using OpenGL. Therefore, during normal gameplay, you will not have this kind of issue. So, that was our comparison video. What did you think of the new performance of Vulcan in Citra? If you enjoyed this type of content, don't forget to click like and subscribe to the channel to receive updates on emulation every week. Until the next video.